Before we get started with the video, I'd like to give a quick shout out to KiCadProjects.com by NextPCB. This is a great platform where you can share your own KiCad-related projects or even explore and recreate projects shared by other users. What's even better is that KiCadProjects.com will donate $10 to KiCad on your behalf for every project you share on their website, a great way to support the community. Now, coming back to the video. In this tutorial, I'll be sharing a few useful tips and tricks that can help you save both time and money while working with KiCad. Normally, when we want to place commonly used components like resistors in our schematic, here's what we usually do. First, we go to the Place Components option and search for a resistor. Then, we add it to the schematic editor. Now, if we press E on the component, you'll notice that there's no value or footprint assigned to it. That means we have to add those manually, which can take extra time. Instead of doing that manually, let's make this process faster using two helpful plugins. Go to Plugin and Content Manager. Go to the Libraries section and install alternate KiCad libraries and simple libraries. Once both libraries are installed, go back to the schematic editor. Now, click on Place Components again. This time, instead of searching for a resistor, try searching for the specific value you need, for example, type 1K. You'll now see a 1K resistor with its footprint. You can use this plugin and this method for capacitor and various other components to save a little time. Let's say you want to duplicate a component with the same value multiple times in your schematic. Normally, you can do this by adding the same component again from the Place Component option. Another way is to simply duplicate the existing component by pressing Ctrl plus D. But there's an even easier method. To do that, click on the Place Component option. Select the component that you want to place. Now, enable the option Place Repeated Copies and click OK. After this, you can place the same component multiple times just by clicking with your mouse and no need to press any extra keys. Once you're done placing the components, simply press the Escape key to exit the mode. Using shortcuts in KiCad can help you save a lot of time while working on your projects. To view all the available shortcuts, here's what you need to do. Go to the Preferences menu at the top. Then, click on the Preferences option from the drop-down list. Now, select Hotkeys. Here, you'll see a complete list of all the keyboard shortcuts available in KiCad. You can use these to speed up your workflow and make designing much faster. The next tip is about using global labels, which can help you save time and also make your schematic look cleaner and more professional. As you can see, this design looks a bit messy and unorganized. By using global labels, we can make it look much neater and easier to understand. Global labels are especially useful when working with complex circuits. They allow you to connect different parts of the circuit without having to draw long, messy wires. For instance, let's say we want to add an LED indicator circuit. First, create the LED indicator circuit. Then, copy the required label from your main circuit and add it to the LED indicator circuit to link them together. By doing this, we can avoid drawing messy wires and save time. If you want a more detailed explanation of global labels, you can check out my previous video. I've added the link in the description below. Using design blocks in KiCad can help you save a lot of time, especially when you need to reuse the same circuit in multiple projects. For example, let's say you want to use this power supply circuit in another project. Instead of recreating it from scratch, you can turn it into a design block, which I've already done for this circuit. Now, to use it in a new project, simply click on the design block you want and add it to your schematic. That's it, it's that simple. By using design blocks, you can reuse your existing circuits easily and save a lot of time in your future designs. To learn how to create design blocks, please watch my previous video, which I have linked in the description. Using plugins in KiCad can really help you save time while working on your projects. For example, there's a plugin called KiKit, which allows you to create panels from your PCB design. This not only makes the process faster, but can also help you save money during fabrication. Just like KiCad, there are many other useful plugins that can make your workflow much easier. I've made a separate video where I cover some of these helpful plugins in detail. You can find the link to that video in the description below. Let's say you want to select only the tracks in your PCB design. If you simply try to select the PCB, you'll notice that the entire board gets selected, not just the tracks. To fix this, there's an easy way to select only the tracks using the selection filter. Here's how you can do it step by step. Go to the selection filter option located at the bottom right corner of the KiCad window. First, uncheck the All Items option. Then, enable Only the Tracks option. Now, when you select the PCB, only the tracks will be highlighted. You can use this same method to select other specific items listed under the selection filter as well. In this PCB design, if we open the 3D viewer, you'll notice that some components are missing their 3D models. For this example, I will add a 3D model to this component. To do that, select the component and press E. Now go to 3D models and link your 3D model for the component. Once you've done that, you can view it in 3D by clicking on the 3D viewer. Here, if you look closely, both components are identical, but the 3D model has been added to only one of them. That's because, with this method, we need to add the 3D model manually to each component, which can take extra time when you're working with multiple similar parts. To solve this and add the 3D model to all similar components at once, follow these steps. Go to the footprint editor. Search for your component, then double-click on it to open its properties. Now, add the 3D model just like we did earlier. If you're not sure how to add a 3D model, you can check out my previous video. I've added the link in the description. Once you've added the 3D model, go back to the PCB editor. At this point, if you open the 3D viewer, the model might not appear yet. To make it visible, select the component on the PCB. Right-click on it and choose Update Footprint. Now, when you open the 3D viewer again, you'll see that the 3D model is properly linked. By using this method, you can save a lot of time when adding 3D models to multiple identical components. Just like how we added 3D models to commonly used components, we can also link footprints to commonly used symbols, and this can help you save a lot of time. For example, if we take a commonly used component like a resistor, KiCad doesn't have any footprint linked to it by default. So, every time we add this component, we have to manually link the footprint, which can be time-consuming. Instead, we can do it the same way we did for the 3D models. Go to the symbol editor. Now search for your component from the list. Next, click on Symbol Properties. Now, link the footprint you want based on your requirement. Finally, save the changes. Now, when you go back to the schematic editor and add that component, the footprint will already be linked automatically. By doing this, you can avoid repetitive work and save a lot of time when designing your schematics. The final tip I want to share is to always perform ERC and DRC checks before finalizing your design. Doing this can help you catch and fix potential issues early, which will save time and money during the manufacturing process. If you're not familiar with how to perform or fix ERC, electrical rules check, and DRC, design rules check errors, you can watch my previous video. I've added the link in the description. That's all for now. If you have any helpful tips or tricks that others can benefit from, feel free to share them in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more KiCad tutorials.